Jet Airways founder and former chairman Naresh Goyal, who along with his wife Anita Goyal resigned from the board of cash-strapped carrier, had said in his farewell speech that the decision was not the end of the journey but the start of a brand new chapter. Amid ongoing speculations over the future of Jet Airways, Goyal is likely to submit initial bids for stake in the airline. Among others, four entities have also expressed interest in the bidding process for stake in Jet Airways. It may have lost the crown to stablemate Desire for the calendar year 2018, but a steep decline in sales for the last 3 months of fiscal 2019 has seen the compact sedan lose the advantage to long-time bestseller Maruti Alto. A 4.4% growth in the last quarter as against an over 16% decline in sales of the Desire helped the cause of Maruti Alto. Nine state governments, including Maharashtra, Rajasthan and Tamil Nadu, will raise ₹9,800 crore by selling securities on April 15, the Reserve Bank said yesterday. The auction will be conducted on the Reserve Bank of India core banking solution system, it added. The Reserve Bank further said it will determine the maximum yield or minimum price at which bids will be accepted. Conversations around elections kept Twitter buzzing over the last 1 month, with over 45 million tweets being shared, the microblogging platform said yesterday. Prime Minister Modi emerged as the most mentioned figure during this first phase of the Lok Sabha elections 2019 conversations on Twitter. Interestingly, national security ranked ahead of topics like religion, jobs, agriculture, and taxes and trade in the election conversations. Amazon.com Inc. Chief Executive Officer Jeff Bezos yesterday challenged rival retailers to increase their minimum wages to $16 an hour. Amazon's wage hike came at a time when US unemployment was at a near two-decade low as retailers and shippers were competing for hundreds of thousands of workers for the all-important holiday shopping season. WikiLeaks founder Julian Assange was arrested by British police and carried out of the Ecuadorian embassy on Thursday after his South American hosts abruptly revoked his 7-year asylum, paving the way for his extradition to the United States.